Most people arrive on the Isle of Anglesey via the A55 over the Britannia Bridge. Designed and built by Robert Stephenson to originally be a rail-only bridge, but after a severe fire in 1970, it was converted to a rail and road bridge by having a second tier added to carry road traffic in 1980. Having crossed the Menai Strait, it seemed appropriate to deviate a little northeast to view another iconic bridge, the Menai Suspension Bridge. One of Thomas Telford's many bridges, it opened in 1826, enabling easy access to the island, avoiding the ferry across the somewhat dangerous Menai Strait. A better man than I would attempt this place name. Being one of the longest in the world, it consists of 58 characters and has become a tourist magnet. Driving through Newborough Forest brings you to the car park, giving easy access to Newborough Warren. Having one of the largest dune areas in the UK, it also has a stunning beach. Walking to Llanddwyn Island can be along the beach or through the forest. Although called an island, it only ever gets cut off at a very high tide. Kept completely non-commercial, there are no facilities, but ideal for taking your own picnic. A small beacon seen here on the left was built to guide ships into the strait, but the later lighthouse on the right was in use until the late 70s. The only cottages on the island were built in 1830 for the pilots who guided ships into the Menai Strait, but haven't been occupied since 1943. The pilots also helped man the lifeboat that had been stationed on the island, the cannon being used to signal and muster the crew to action. On a good day, you get a stunning panorama of Snowdonia and the Llyn Peninsula. Llanddwyn Island has to be on a visitor's list and is one of the lesser known gems of Wales, if not Britain. Well worth the 1 mile walk from the car park. Only accessible at low tide, Cribinau Island hosts the 13th century church of St. Quivan. Originally part of the mainland, it appears erosion turned this small headland into an island. Erosion was so bad, a wall had to be built around the island to stop graves being washed into the sea. Although you can access the island, the church itself was locked when we visited. South Stack Lighthouse was built in 1809, accessible via a bridge after descending 400 steps. The tower rises 92 feet and is still in use. Reopened to the public in 1997, I enjoyed our visit, but not so much the 400 steps back up. The cliffs form part of the RSPB reserve and can host in excess of 8,000 birds during the breeding season. During our visits, we see many wildflowers and insects. At the most westerly point on Anglesey, South Stack is a superb reserve with a variety of heathland and farmland, with the added bonus of dramatic sea cliffs. The port of Holyhead is the largest town on the island, and built in the Victorian era at 1.7 miles, it has the longest breakwater in the UK. It is also one of the main links to the Republic of Ireland. The steep footpath drops you onto the beach from the Anglesey coastal path. Church Bay is a stunningly beautiful, unassuming spot, made up of rocks, pebbles and a lovely beach. Moelfre Head stands guard over Cemaes Bay on the north coast, an area of outstanding natural beauty. Moving easterly brings you to Cemaes Village. Some fishing takes place, but is mainly a tourist hotspot with its attractive harbour and beach. This ex-lifeboat was decommissioned in 1932. After a full restoration, it was relaunched in 2009 and is looked after by the Cemaes Boat Club. After a wander around the harbour, many bars and cafes will help you while away the time in this lovely location. Amlwch Port grew quickly in the 18th century due to the booming copper industry, with the Paris Mountain Mine nearby. The largest in the world at the time. With the decline of the mine, other activities were taken on, shipbuilding being one, but it also declined and left Amlwch without any real commercial prospects. Having already visited a couple of times, whilst wandering along the quay, I felt the need to investigate how to get over to the far side. I had missed the steps that take you up onto the track that starts your ramble around the west side. Not just a different view of the harbour, you can still see many relics from its mining heritage. I was quite surprised to see how many wildflowers and insects I saw. For the most part, I was completely alone and enjoyed the ramble immensely. Thank you. Amlwch Port tends not to attract so many visitors, possibly because it is not too commercial and it doesn't have a local beach. But for me, there always seems to be some activity going on to hold my interest. I love the place. Northeast of Anglesey is Point Linus. It is possible to walk out to the lighthouse area, but it is now holiday accommodation. Nearly all of the Anglesey coast is designated as an area of outstanding natural beauty, and Traeth Dulles is no exception. A peaceful haven worth a wander up to the wrecked boats at low water, but care should be taken to avoid an incoming tide. The mud and sand flats encourage many varieties of waders and seabirds, all after the many invertebrates. Moelfre is yet another picturesque small harbour village that seems to have a dreamy atmosphere. There is nothing better than lunch in Anne's pantry followed by a coastal walk towards the lifeboat station. The statue of Richard Evans, born in Moelfre, stands proud. He gave 50 years of service to the RNLI and was awarded the RNLI Gold Medal twice for bravery. The lifeboat station has had a long and busy history and was established in 1854. Purely funded by donations, all the lifeboat crew are volunteers and are dedicated to saving lives at sea. The station is usually open to the public and we found everyone welcoming. A Tamar class and a D class inshore inflatable are stationed here with the older Oakley class RNLB bird's eye being exhibited after 20 years of service and retired in 1990. Bird's eye was presented to the RNLI by the well-known frozen food company of the same name. The village called Red Wharf Bay is at the western end of the bay of the same name. Once a thriving port, it is mainly pleasure boats that adorn the bay's safe anchorage. It can get very busy at peak times, as there are three restaurants in the village which help draw the visitors. Being bordered by dunes and salt marsh, with a vast area of salt flats at low water, brings many varieties of birds. The bay spans 2.5 miles, and at the eastern end it becomes a much quieter spot to sit and while away some time, or explore the pebbly foreshore. Being privately owned, a toll has to be paid to access Penmon Point, but it's worth it to experience such a superb area with views across the Puffin Island. Or a walk along the foreshore is not to be missed. There are two lighthouse keepers' cottages and a cafe. There is also the priory and church, with a dovecot and a well to visit, all accessible before the toll. A very popular location, Beaumaris has all the trappings of a seaside town, many shops, cafes and a pier. For me it's worth visiting for the breathtaking view across to Snowdonia, weather permitting of course. Completes our clockwise look at the Isle of Anglesey. We will be back. Thank you for watching.